Priya students, welcome to our online classes of medical diagnostics for class 11. I think you all have cleared your doubt about the physical examination of urine, and now today we are going to start about the topic named as chemical analysis of urine. So when you are doing the chemical analysis of urine, so what will be the different chemical that you can use here, okay? The first one, glucose, ketone bodies, protein, blood, bile salt, bile pigment, urobilinogen and nitrite. These are very important chemicals that we have to detect in the urine, because by detecting these chemicals we can diagnose different kinds of endocrine problems and metabolic problems and the kidney problems of our body. Now let's see how can we do that. Today we are going to learn about only glucose, okay? So glucose, by which test you can diagnose the presence of glucose in blood? The name of the test is Benedict's test, okay? This is very simple test, and when the school will reopen, then you will do the test in our lab also. So what is the basic principle of the test that we have to learn, okay? So first listen carefully. What you have to do, you have to take a test tube. There you have to take 5 ml of Benedict reagent, okay? 5 ml of Benedict reagent you have to take. Then you have to pour 8 to 10 drops of urine with the help of one dropper. Now you have to heat it, okay? You have to heat the test tube. Then what will happen when the urine and the Benedict reagent mixture will change its color? There will be color change. So when there will be color change, that means in the urine glucose is present. But if there will be no color change, that means there is no glucose in the Benedict, there are no glucose present in the urine sample, okay? This is very simple test. So what is the basic principle? So urinary sugar, when it will be boiled in Benedict reagent, so it will reduce the copper sulfate, because the Benedict reagent is made up of copper sulfate only. So when the copper sulfate, that means Benedict reagent, along with the urinary sugar, it will be boiled, okay? Because I have told you previously that we have to put the heat here. So when it will be boiled, then reddish cuprous oxide precipitate will be formed in the hot alkaline medium, and that alkaline medium is the also provided by the Benedict reagent. So the intensity of which is proportional to the amount of sugar present. If large amount of sugar will be present, color change will also be large. If less amount of sugar will be present, color change will also be less, okay? So the result will be reported as the 1 plus, 2 plus, etc. depending upon the color change. If it is less color change, that means 1 plus, quite more 2 plus, like that. Reagent, what are the different reagent? Actually in Benedict's reagent we can see 17.3 gram of crystalline copper sulfate and 800 ml of distilled water along with 100 gram of sodium carbonate will be mixed just to give the alkaline medium. So you have to mix it in well manner and then add 175 gram of sodium citrate also, and you have to keep it in a bottle, amber colored bottle, at 25 degree centigrade to 35 degree centigrade, okay? And it will be stable for 1 year. And now what is the procedure? 5 ml of Benedict reagent will be taken in a glass tube and 8 to 10 drops of urine will be given there. Mix it well, boil for 2 to 3 minutes and cool the tube and change the and observe the color change, okay? Now the next one, that was the Benedict test, and you can determine the glucose of urine by using the QDX urine analyzer also. So what is the meaning of QDX urine analyzer? Actually the glucose present in urine can be oxidized by the glucose oxidase, okay, that is one kind of enzyme to form the glucuronic acid and hydrogen peroxide. Okay, so hydrogen peroxide, it will release the neo-ecotypes oxide under the action of the peroxidase, because glucose oxidase and peroxidase, these will be helping the glucose to be oxidized. Okay, and it oxidizes the potassium iodide, which produces the color change. And sensitivity will be almost 50 to 100 mg per dl. And the reactive ingredients can be the enzymes, especially glucose oxidase, glucose peroxidase, potassium iodine, buffer, and the non-reactive ingredients. Now, what will be the interpretation of the result? If there is no change in color, means glucose is negative. If the cloudy green color will appear, that means very less amount of glucose is present. If it is yellow to orange, then the amount of glucose is quite higher. If it is orange precipitate, it is more higher. Okay, and that means more higher. Here we can see it like, we can say like that, and here only one. That means some amount of glucose is present. This rate is quite higher, this is or higher, and this one will be more higher. Okay, so we can put it, we can indicate it like this also. False positive reaction can also be there, okay, due to the presence of non-carbohydrate substances, okay. So, like the ascorbic acid, then the homogenistic acid. Homogenistic acid is one kind of thing, one kind of acid that can be prepared due to the metabolic disorder, and creatinine and uric acid also. And reducing sugar like the lactose, galactose, fructose, pentose, these will also give the positive reaction. So instead of glucose, if these will be present, it can also give the false positive result. And the dipstick technique is specific for glucose and eliminates the false positive reaction due to the substances. Which substances? Lactose, galactose, fructose and pentose. Okay, just because of these substances we can get the false positive result also. Now, what will be the clinical significance? That means if the glucose will be present in blood, which kind of situation can be occurred? The first one, diabetes mellitus, endocrine disorder, okay, any kind of endocrine disorder. It can be diabetes mellitus, Cushing syndrome, pancreatic tumor, hyperthyroidism, hyperpituitarism, any kind of. Then the pheochromocytoma, carcinoma of pancreas, that means malignancy or cancer in pancreas, or pancreatitis, that means the cell degeneration in the pancreas. Okay, now the if there is the any kind of central nervous system disorder or brain tumor, asphyxia, burn, infection, myocardial infarction, actually it is the problem of the heart. Liver disease, glycogen storage disease, in case of obesity also sometimes the glucose level can be higher in the blood. In case of pregnancy also it can happen, and due to the age, okay, old age, glucose intolerance also can cause the presence of glucose in urine. And the last one is the glycosuria without hyperglycemia. That means if the glucose will be present in urine but not in blood. Okay, that means glucose level is not higher in blood. Glucose level is not higher in blood, but the glucose level is higher in urine. In urine, the glucose level is higher, but in blood, the glucose level is down. In urine, the glucose level is high, but in blood, the glucose level is down. That means it is the renal tubular dysfunction. Okay, and in other cases, renal glycosuria and elementary glycosuria also can be occurred. Elementary glycosuria means it can be due to the problem in the digestive tract. Okay, so in the next class, we are going to learn about the ketone bodies. This is up to today's class. I hope you all have enjoyed. And thank you very much.